Again, to give you the name, they go over them, but they have to have one.
Good morning to all students. Welcome to lecture series of anatomy. We have started lecture series of neuroanatomy, and the professor has already taken one lecture, that is gross anatomy and microscopic structure of spinal cord. Today we'll see about ascending tracts of spinal cord. Now, before going to our topic, we'll revise previous topic shortly. All of you know that in spinal cord centrally there is gray matter and peripherally is white matter. This gray matter, it is present in the form of H, and as it is gray matter, it is mainly made up of cell bodies of neurons. And in spinal cord, this gray matter, it is divided into nuclei. So gray matter, it is having posterior horn, which is sensory in function, anterior horn, which is motor in function, and lateral horn, which is present in thoracic and sacral segments, and it is autonomic in function. So in the posterior horn, there are different nuclei, that is, at the tip there is a nucleus postromarginalis, then next is substantia gelatinosa, then nucleus properius, visceral afferent nucleus, and dorsal nucleus or nucleus of Clark's column. In this lateral horn, there are two nuclei, that is intermedio medial and intermedio lateral. Ventral horn, it is divided into three nuclear groups: lateral, central and medial. This gray matter, it is again divided into 10 laminae, that is laminae of Rexed, and this posterior horn, it is having 6 laminae. This lamina 1, it corresponds with the nucleus postromarginalis. Lamina 2, it corresponds with substantia gelatinosa. Lamina 3 to 6, they correspond with nucleus properius, and in lamina 7, there is nucleus dorsalis or nucleus of Clark's column, intermedio medial and intermedio lateral nuclei. And lamina 8 and 9, they are present in ventral horn, and last lamina, that is lamina 10, it is present around the central canal. So this is about the gray matter. Peripherally in spinal cord there is white matter, and this white matter, it is divided into three funiculi: posterior funiculus, or it is also called as posterior white column, lateral funiculus and anterior funiculus. And these funiculi, they are occupied by different ascending and descending tracts. So this diagram, it shows ascending tracts of spinal cord. In the posterior funiculus, there is fasciculus gracilis, fasciculus cuneatus, then dorsolateral tract of lizard. In lateral funiculus, there are posterior spinocerebellar, anterior spinocerebellar, lateral spinothalamic, spinotactyl, spinoolivary, and in anterior funiculus there is anterior spinothalamic tract. So these are the different ascending tracts present in spinal cord, which form part of white matter of spinal cord. Now this diagram, it shows different descending tracts. We will see in the next lecture about this descending tracts. So first we will see about functioning of this central nervous system, how this central nervous system, it functions. So main function of this central nervous system, it collects information from the periphery, then that information, it is processed and analyzed in cortex, then decision is taken, and then order is sent to the spinal cord, and through this spinal cord, that order, it is sent to the effector organ, and that effector organ, that is the muscle or gland. So this is the main functioning of this central nervous system. Now in this diagram, you can see there is the candle which is lightened. Then this is upper extremity finger, it is touched to this flame of candle. Then transverse section of spinal cord here, it shows its posterior root, anterior root of spinal nerve, which joins, they form the spinal nerve, which divides into anterior ramus and posterior ramus. And here is the cerebral cortex. Now, when you accidentally touch to this flame of candle, what happens? The peripheral receptors in the skin for that hot temperature, they get stimulated, and that stimulus, it is carried through the sensory fibers of peripheral nerves, and here that is the peripheral processes of this dorsal root ganglia, which is situated in spinal nerve. Now these sensations, they are carried through these central processes. They relay in the spinal cord, and the fibers arising from this spinal cord, they cross to the opposite side and they ascend upward as ascending fibers or ascending tracts, and then they relay in the cerebral cortex. That means that sensory information from the periphery, it is carried by these peripheral nerves to the spinal cord, and from the spinal cord to the cortex by the ascending tracts. Now that information, it is processed and analyzed here, then decision is taken, and then that order is sent to the spinal cord, and that order is the to remove hand, and that order, it is carried by this ventral root of spinal nerve to the spinal nerve, and then through this anterior ramus to the effector organ, that is here is the muscle, here is shown biceps brachii, contraction of this muscle that leads to flexion, and there is that hand is taken away. So this touching to this flame and removing your hand, that happens only in 0.1 to 0.2 seconds, and within this 0.1 to 0.2 seconds, that information goes to cerebral cortex, that is there is analyzed, decision taken, and then decision is sent as order to the muscle, and there is contraction and you remove your hand. So this is the functioning of that central nervous system. From this you understand that these ascending fibers, they carry the sensory information. So these ascending tracts of spinal cord, they are sensory in function, so they are also called as sensory pathways. Now the decision which is taken in cerebral cortex, and order is given, and that order, it is in the form of nerve impulses that traverses through descending fibers to the spinal cord, and these descending fibers that forms the descending tracts of spinal cord, and these descending tracts of spinal cord, they are motor in function, so they are also called as descending, they are also called as motor pathways. So ascending tracts, they are called as sensory pathways, and descending tracts, they are called as motor pathways due to its function. Now what is this tract? Bundle of nerve fibers within central nervous system is called as tract. And these nerve fibers which are present in tract, they are having the same origin, course, termination and functions. In case of peripheral nervous system, bundle of nerve fibers, that is called as nerves, as you know, ulnar nerve, axillary nerve, radial nerve. These tracts, sometimes they are also called as fasciculi or leminskaya. These tracts, they are named, and that naming of tracts, that depends on the structures connected by these tracts. Name of the tract, it consists of two components. First components denote origin, and second component denotes termination. For example, spinothalamic tract. In its first, that is the spino, means it starts or it begins in the spinal cord, and thalamic, second component, that is it ends in the thalamus, that is the spinothalamic. Second example, corticospinal tract. Here cortico is the first component, that means it starts in the cortex, that is the cerebral cortex, and it ends in spinal cord, that is the corticospinal tract. Classification of tracts, these tracts, they are divided into ascending tracts and descending tracts. There is also third variety of tract, that is called as intersegmental tracts, but they are only present in spinal cord. These intersegmental tracts, they consist of both ascending fibers and descending fibers, and they connect the adjacent segments of spinal cord. Now we will see about this ascending tracts or sensory tracts or sensory pathways. These ascending tracts, what is its function? They carry somatic and visceral sensations from the periphery to the cerebral cortex or to the brain. Now, what is sensation? So, sensation is the feeling produced by stimulus. And this, what is this stimulus? This stimulus is the disturbance in the environment, and that may be external stimulus, that means it may be in external environment, or it may be internal stimulus, that means it is present within the body in the internal environment. Now, sensation, they are of two types, that is somatic sensation and visceral sensation. These somatic sensation, they are of two types: spatial somatic sensation, examples vision, hearing, olfaction, and these sensation, they are carried by cranial nerves. General somatic sensations, they are of extraceptive and proprioceptive. Extraceptive means these sensations, they are generated due to the stimulus in the external environment. That means they are passively imposed on the body by the external stimulus. And example is of these extraceptive sensations are the pain, touch, temperature. And peripheral receptors for this extraceptive sensation, that is the free nerve endings for pain, Krauze's end bulb for the cold temperature, Ruffini's endings for hot temperature, and also Meissner's corpuscles and Merkel's disc. So these are the extraceptive peripheral receptors which are situated in skin. Second is the proprioceptive sensation, and this proprioceptive sensation, it is generated by the movements of the body, that is they are actively formed by the movements of the body, and these movements of body that stimulates the peripheral receptors which are present in muscle, tendons, joints, ligaments and bones. And this sensation, like position of body in space, position of joint, contraction of muscle, stretching of muscle, and these are the proprioceptive sensations. And receptors for this sensation are the mainly muscle spindle, Pacinian corpuscles and Golgi tendon organ. So there is also third variety of sensation, that is called as interoceptive or visceroceptive, and they are generated in the wall of the viscera. So these general somatic sensations, they are carried by these ascending tracts of cord. So general somatic means that is the extraceptive sensation and proprioceptive sensation. Now these sensation which are carried by ascending tracts, they are carried at two level. One at the conscious level, that is at the cerebral cortex. At the conscious level, at the cerebral cortex means we are aware of that sensation and there is perception of that sensation, that is the conscious level. This sensation, they are also carried at unconscious level, but at that time we are not aware of that sensation or there is no perception of that sensation. For example, this particularly proprioceptive sensation, they are carried to spinal cord for the reflex muscular activity, and also they are carried to cerebellum for the maintenance of tone. And by maintaining tone, muscle tone by this cerebellum, this cerebral cortex produce skillful, purposeful, coordinated movements. And this type of sensation, they are not felt. The sensory pathways which go to cerebral cortex, in its root, in its course, they consist of three neurons. So these are also called as three neuronal pathways. And these neurons, they are named as first order neuron, second order neuron and third order neuron. Also these tracts are cross. Which tracts are cross? The tracts which are, which goes to conscious level, that is at the cerebral cortex, they are cross tracts because body is represented contralaterally in the cerebral cortex. That means right side of body, it is represented in left side of cerebral cortex and vice versa. Now in this diagram, you can see that three neuronal pathway of these ascending tracts. First order neuron, it is situated in dorsal root ganglia, and this dorsal root ganglia, it is present on the dorsal root of spinal nerve. Peripheral processes of this first order neuron, they carry sensation from the peripheral receptors. Then these central processes of these neurons, they carry it to dorsal horn of spinal cord, and here these sensations they relay, and second order neurons they are present in this spinal cord, that is dorsal horn of the spinal cord. Now the fibers arising from these second order neurons, they cross to opposite side and they ascend upward through the spinal cord, medulla, pons and midbrain as a ascending tracts of spinal cord, and they relay in third order neuron which is situated in thalamus. And this third order neuron fibers, they pass through posterior limb of internal capsule and project to primary sensory area, that is the area number 312 in the post central gyrus of cerebral cortex. So these are the three neurons of this ascending tracts. First order neuron, it is situated in dorsal root ganglia. Second order neuron, it is situated in dorsal horn of posterior horn. They are also situated in nucleus cuneatus and nucleus gracilis in the lower part of medulla. And third order neuron, it is situated in thalamus. Now the ascending tracts or sensory tracts which carry sensations at unconscious level, they are bineuronal pathway. That means they consist of only two neurons in its course. Example, spinocerebellar tracts, we will see later on. Some pathways, ascending pathways, they are also sensory ascending pathways, they are also multineuronal pathways. For example, auditory pathway, optic pathway. If you see this auditory pathway, first neuron it lies in spiral ganglia, then second in the cochlear nuclei, third in the superior olivary nuclei, fourth in the inferior colliculus, and fifth is in the medial geniculate body. And from this medial geniculate body, the fibers project to the auditory sensory area for the perception of hearing. So this is the multineuronal pathway. This table shows ascending tracts located in different funiculi of spinal cord. Dorsal funiculus, it mainly consists of fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus. Lateral funiculus, it consists of posterior spinocerebellar, anterior spinocerebellar, lateral spinothalamic, spinotectal, spinoolivary and dorsolateral tract. Ventral funiculus, it mainly consists of anterior spinothalamic tract. Now we will see one by one individual tracts. But when you study any tract, that may be ascending tract or that may be descending tract, if you study that tract under these points, it is very easy to remember and learn that tract, and it is very easy for you to write in examination. So when we study tract, it will be studied under following points: location of tract, then functions of tract, origin, course of tract, termination and clinical anatomy of tract. So first we will see about ascending tracts in the dorsal funiculus, and these are the fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus. First point, that is location of tract. This fasciculus gracilis present along entire length of spinal cord, that means it is present throughout the length of spinal cord. This fasciculus cuneatus present in cervical and the upper thoracic segments on the lateral side of fasciculus gracilis, that means it is absent in the lower thoracic segment, lumbar segment and the sacral segment. So this is the location. Now in this diagram you can see that this first figure, that is the transverse section of cervical spinal cord, in which you can see that these two fasciculi, that is fasciculus gracilis which is present medially and fasciculus cuneatus which is present laterally. Arrangement of fibers in this fasciculi: limb fibers, lower limb fibers, they are present medially, trunk fibers, they are present in the middle, and upper limb fibers, they are present laterally. Now in the second diagram, that is the transverse section at the lower thoracic cord, and here you can see only fasciculus gracilis, there is no fasciculus cuneatus. Now functions of tract: it conveys sensation of fine touch, that is tactile localization and two-point discrimination. This tactile localization means ability to localize exactly part of the skin that is touch, that is the tactile localization. Two-point discrimination means ability to locate two separate points on the skin that is touch. So that is the tactile localization and two-point discrimination. It also conveys sensations of the body position and the joint movement, that is the proprioceptive sensations to the conscious level. It also conveys sensation of deep pressure, vibration and stereognosis. This stereognosis means that is ability to identify size and shape of familiar object with close eyes, that is the stereognosis. Now we'll see about this origin, course and termination of this tract. Now this lower lumbar segment of spinal cord, this is the dorsal root ganglia, peripheral processes of this ganglia that carry these sensations from the peripheral receptors, that is from the muscle spindle, Golgi tendon organ, Pacinian corpuscles, Meissner's corpuscles. Then these sensations through these processes carried to spinal cord through the central processes of this dorsal root ganglia, that is the first order neurons. And then these processes, they enter into spinal cord through the dorsal root of spinal nerve and they ascend upward without relay in posterior horn of spinal cord. They ascend upward through the posterior funiculus as a fasciculus gracilis. So this fasciculus gracilis, it is made up of central processes of dorsal root ganglia. Now from the upper thoracic segments and cervical segments, these sensations, they are carried by these peripheral processes of neurons of this first order neurons situated in dorsal root ganglia. Then they are carried through these central processes. Then they again without relay in posterior horn, they ascend upward through the posterior cuniculus, but here they lies on the lateral aspect of this fasciculus gracilis and this ascending fiber, that is the fasciculus cuneatus. Now these two fasciculi, they ascend upward through the spinal cord up to the lower part of medulla. In the lower part of medulla, there are two nuclei on each side, that is the nucleus gracilis and nucleus cuneatus, and these fibers of these fasciculi, they relay in the neurons of these in nuclei, and here are the second order neurons for this tract. Now the fibers arising from neurons in these nuclei, they goes ventrally and medially and they decussate with the fibers of the opposite side in the midline, ventral to the central gray matter, and they go to the contralateral side and continues as the medial lemniscus. Now this decussation, that is decussation of these efferents of nucleus gracilis and nucleus cuneatus, that decussation is called as great sensory decussation, and the fibers or efferents of this nuclei, they are called as internal arcuate fibers. As they are present internally, takes arcuate course, so they are called as internal arcuate fibers. Now this medial lemniscus, it is called as lemniscus because it is a flat ribbon like bundle of fibers present on the medial aspect. And what is this medial lemniscus? It is the efferents of nucleus cuneatus and nucleus gracilis of the contralateral side, which carries the proprioceptive sensations and fine touch from the contralateral side. Now these fibers in medial lemniscus, they ascend upward through the medulla, pons and midbrain, and these fibers, they relay in the third order neuron, which is situated in thalamus, that is the ventral posterolateral nucleus of thalamus. This thalamus, it is made up of many nuclei. Out of these, there is one nucleus that is called as ventral posterior, and this ventral posterior, it is again divided into ventral posterolateral and ventral posteromedial. So these fibers of medial lemniscus, they relay in the ventral posterolateral nucleus, which are the third order neurons. And now the fibers arising from these neurons of ventral posterolateral nucleus, they pass through posterior limb of internal capsule and they project to the primary sensory area in the cerebral cortex, that is area number 3, 1, 2, and there is perception of that sensation. So this is about the origin, course and termination of this fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus. In this diagram, this is the transverse section at the lower part of the medulla. In this you can see that is nucleus gracilis, nucleus cuneatus, and fibers arising from this nucleus gracilis and nucleus cuneatus, these are called as internal arcuate fibers. They decussate with the similar fibers from the opposite side. That decussation is called as great sensory decussation, and they go to opposite side and they continues as the medial lemniscus. Arrangement of fibers in this nuclei. Nucleus gracilis, there are limb fibers, they are present on medial aspect, and in this medial lemniscus they are present anteriorly, and upper limb fibers which are present laterally in this nucleus cuneatus, they are present posteriorly, and that decussation is called as great sensory decussation. Clinical anatomy of this tract. Lesions of this posterior white column tracts, that is the fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus, they are common in the syphilis, and in this there are degeneration of these fibers of fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus, and that is called as stapes dorsalis. So what is stapes dorsalis? It is the condition in which there is degeneration or there are degenerative changes in this fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus, and which is common in syphilis, and that leads to loss of sensation of position of lower limb, which affects equilibrium and gait. Patient is unable to tell the position of his lower limb unless he sees them due to lack of proprioceptive sensations. Also there is loss of 2-point discrimination, fine touch, that is tactile localization, and stereognosis. So this is about the clinical anatomy of tracts of posterior funiculus. Now we will see about tracts of anterolateral funiculus. In that first we will see about lateral spinothalamic tract. Location of this tract. It is present throughout the length of spinal cord in lateral funiculus, medial to anterior spinocerebellar tract, and dorsal to spinotectal tract. So it is present throughout the length of spinal cord in the lateral funiculus. Function of this tract, it conveys pain and temperature sensation from the opposite side of limb and trunk. From the head and neck region, this sensation, that is pain and temperature, it is carried by trigeminal nerve. Now origin, course, and termination of this tract. The peripheral processes of these dorsal root ganglia neurons, they carry these sensations from the peripheral receptors, that is free nerve endings for the pain sensation, Krause's end bulb for the cold temperature, and Ruffini's endings for hot temperature. This central process of these neurons, they carry this sensation through this dorsal root of spinal nerve in the dorsal gray column. And here these fibers, they relay in the laminae, mainly 2 to 6 laminae, and fibers arising from the neurons of this dorsal horn neurons, they cross to the opposite side, ventral to the central canal, and they goes to opposite side lateral funiculus, and then it ascend as a lateral spinothalamic tract. So what is this lateral spinothalamic tract, or what is the origin? Lateral spinothalamic tract, it is formed by efferents of neurons which are situated in dorsal horn of spinal cord, and mainly in the lamina number 1, 4, 5 and 6. Then this tract from the lateral funiculus, it ascends upward through the medulla, pons and midbrain, and then these fibers, they relay in the ventral posterolateral nucleus of thalamus. These are the third order neurons, and from this the fibers, they project to primary sensory cortex, which pass through posterior limb of internal capsule, and there is perception of that sensation, that is the pain and temperature sensation. So this is the origin, course, and termination of this lateral spinothalamic tract. Clinical anatomy of this tract. Unilateral damage leads to loss of pain and temperature sensation from opposite side of body below the lesion. Chordotomy. This chordotomy, it is the surgical procedure in which this anterolateral funiculus or spinal cord is cut. In this lateral spinothalamic tract, these vein fibers, they are situated anterior and most superficial to the temporal fibers. And cutting of this anterolateral funiculus in this chordotomy, there is damage to this vein fibers, and it is usually performed in cervical region because these vein fibers, they are most superficial in this tract, and it is done to relieve severe pain associated with malignancies or cancers. Then involvement of this decussating fibers of tract, that is crossing fibers of tract in the anterior white funicula, that is anterior to the central canal, in case of syringomyelia, leads to bilateral loss of pain and temperature below the lesion. And the syringomyelia means that is there are presence of cavities or cyst in the gray matter of spinal cord around the central canal, and as these cavities, they increase in size, they may cause pressure on these crossing fibers of lateral spinothalamic tract, and that leads to loss of pain and temperature sensation. Then next is the anterior spinothalamic tract. As it is present in the anterior funiculus, it is present between the spinal cord and thalamus. It is called as anterior spinothalamic tract. Location of this tract, it is present throughout the length of spinal cord in the anterior funiculus, medial to ventral root of spinal nerve and dorsal to vestibulospinal tract. It is present medial to emerging fibers of ventral root of spinal nerve. Function of this tract, it conveys sensation of crude touch, pressure, tickle sensation and itch sensation from the opposite side of body. Clinical anatomy. Before that, we will see that origin, course and termination of this tract. Now in this figure, that is neurons of this dorsal root ganglia, they carry sensations from the peripheral receptor, that is sensation of touch, pressure, that is touch means crude touch, pressure, sensation of tickle and itch by these peripheral processes. Then these central processes, they carry these sensations to the spinal cord through the dorsal root of spinal nerve. Then these fibers, they ascend for two segments, ascend or descend, and then they relay in lamina 3 to 6, that is mainly the nucleus properius, that is the second order neurons, and fibers arising from these neurons in the dorsal horn, they cross to the opposite side in the white, anterior white commissure, and they go to the opposite side anterior funiculus, and they ascend upward as the anterior spinothalamic tract. This tract, it ascends upward through the medulla pons and midbrain, and these fibers, they relay in the ventral posterolateral nucleus of thalamus, which are the third order neurons, and from these neurons, these fibers from these neurons of thalamus, they project to the cerebral cortex, that is primary sensory area number 312, which is situated in post central gyrus. So this is the origin, course and termination of anterior spinothalamic tract. Clinical anatomy of this tract. Injury to this anterior spinothalamic tract leads to loss of sensation of crude touch, pressure, tickle and itch sensation from opposite side of body. Now we will see about the spinocerebellar tracts. As these spinocerebellar tracts, they carry proprioceptive sensations, that is unconscious proprioceptive sensations, to the cerebellum. So it is the bineuronal pathway, that means in its course there are only two neurons. So first is the posterior spinocerebellar tract. As it is present in the posterior part of lateral funiculus, present between spinal cord and the cerebellum, so it is called as posterior spinocerebellar tract. Location of this tract, it starts from the L3 segment of spinal cord. That means it is absent below the L3 segment. That means lower lumbar sacral segments, it is absent. It is present in lateral funiculus, ventral to dorsolateral tract of leisure and dorsal to anterior spinocerebellar tract, and it is uncrossed tract. Why it is uncrossed tract? Because in the cerebellum, body is represented ipsilaterally. That means right side of body, it is represented in the right side of cerebellum. In the cerebral cortex, it is opposite. Right side of body, it is represented in the left side of cerebral cortex. So there is crossing, and here crossing is absent, that is they are uncrossed. Function of this tract, it conveys unconscious proprioceptive impulses from individual muscles of lower limb and trunk, and this information is useful in coordinating various actions of individual muscles in posture maintenance and body movements. So this is the location and function of this tract. Now we'll see about origin, course and termination of posterior spinocerebellar tract. This is the dorsal root ganglia, that is first neuron. Peripheral processes, they carry that sensations from peripheral part, that is the peripheral receptor, that is mainly from the muscle spindle, Golgi tendon organ, then Vachinian corpuscles, and some extraperceptive sensations also goes through this tract at unconscious level from the lower limb and trunk. Then the central processes, they carry these sensations to spinal cord through the dorsal root of spinal nerve, and these fibers, they relay in the nucleus dorsalis or nucleus of Klar's column. And as you know, this nucleus dorsalis or nucleus of Klar's column, it is present only in the C8 to L3 segments of spinal cord. That means it is absent in cervical segments, it is absent in lower lumbar and sacral segments. So this tract, it starts from the L3 segment because this nucleus, it is absent in lower lumbar and sacral segments. Now after relay in this nucleus dorsalis, efferents of this nucleus, they runs laterally on the same side towards the lateral funiculus, and then they ascend upward as a posterior spinocerebellar tract. So what is the origin of this posterior spinocerebellar tract? These are the efferents of nucleus of Klar's column or nucleus dorsalis of the same side. Then this tract, it ascends up ipsilaterally upwards up to the lower part of medulla, and then it enters into inferior cerebellar peduncle and terminate in the cerebellum of the same side. So there are only two neurons. First neuron, it is situated in this dorsal root ganglia, and second neuron, it is situated in this posterior horn, that is the nucleus dorsalis or nucleus of Klar's column. So this is the origin, course and termination of this posterior spinocerebellar tract. Now this nucleus, it is present only in the thoracic and upper lumbar segments. It is absent in cervical segments, that Klar's column nucleus absent in cervical segment. So proprioceptive sensations from the upper extremity to the cerebellum, they are carried by other pathway, and that is called as cuneocerebellar tract. So what is this cuneocerebellar tract? It is the counterpart of that posterior spinocerebellar tract, and it carries proprioceptive sensations from the upper extremity. And so as nucleus of Klar's column does not extend above T1 segment, so proprioceptive sensations from upper extremity are carried by cuneocerebellar tract. So origin and course and termination of this tract, as it is only present in the cervical segments, fibers arising in this cervical segment, that is the dorsal root ganglia neurons, peripheral processes from the upper extremity carry that proprioceptive sensations. Central processes of these neurons, they carry to the spinal cord, but without relay in the spinal cord, they ascend upward in the posterior funiculus along with the fasciculus cuneatus, and they ascend upward along with this fasciculus cuneatus up to the lower part of medulla, and in the lower part of medulla there is one nucleus which is present on dorsolateral aspect of this nucleus cuneatus, and that is called as accessory cuneate nucleus. That is the second neuron, it is present in this accessory cuneate nucleus. And now the fibers which arise from this accessory cuneate nucleus, they are also called as external arcuate fibers or cuneocerebellar fiber tract. These external arcuate fibers, they are also called as posterior external arcuate fibers because they are present posteriorly and externally, and they take the arcuate course, so they are called as posterior external arcuate fibers. There are also other anterior external arcuate fibers, but we will see that when we study medulla. So this posterior external arcuate fibers, they are nothing but the efferents of this accessory cuneate nucleus. Now this cuneocerebral tract, it ascends and then it enters into inferior cerebellar peduncle in medulla and then terminate in cerebellum. So this cuneocerebellar tract or cuneocerebellar fibers, it is the counterpart of this posterior spinocerebellar tract which carries the proprioceptive sensations from the upper extremity. Now next tract, that is the anterior spinocerebellar tract. It is present anterior to the posterior spinocerebellar tract in the lateral funiculus. So location of this tract, present in lateral funiculus, ventral to dorsal spinocerebellar tract and lateral to lateral spinothalamic tract. It is crossed at two sides. First crossing is in the spinal cord and second crossing is in the superior cerebellar peduncle. So due to the double crossing, that same side of the body, it is represented on the same side of cerebellum. Functions of this tract, it conveys unconscious proprioceptive sensations from lower limb and is concerned for general status of posture and movements of entire lower limb. This posterior spinocerebellar tract, it carries proprioceptive sensations from the individual muscles, but this anterior spinocerebellar tract, it carries proprioceptive sensations from the group of muscles. So it is responsible for general status of entire lower limb, not the individual muscle. Origin and course and termination of this tract. Now this first order neurons which are situated in dorsal root ganglia, they carry that proprioceptive sensations from the lower limb and trunk. Then central processes, they carry this sensation to the spinal cord through the dorsal root of spinal nerve to posterior gray column. And here these fibers relay in dorsal horn of spinal cord, mainly in the lamina 5 and 6. And fibers arising from these neurons, which are mainly situated in this lamina 5 and 6, they cross to opposite side and goes to contralateral lateral funiculus and ascends as a anterior spinocerebellar tract. This anterior spinocerebellar tract, it ascends upward through the medulla pons, and in midbrain it goes to the superior cerebellar peduncle. Here it again crosses. So first crossing, it is in the spinal cord, and second crossing, it is in the superior cerebellar peduncle. So same side fibers, they are carried on the same side of the cerebellum, and passing through the superior cerebellar peduncle, these fibers, they terminate in cerebellum. Clinical anatomy of spinocerebellar tracts. Lesions of this tract cause incoordination of muscle activities, that is ataxia, and decrease muscle tone, that is the hypotonia. So these are the major tracts present in, major ascending tracts present in different funicula of spinal cord. Then we will see about these other minor ascending tracts, and these are spinotectal tract, spino olivary tract and spino reticular tract. So first we'll see about this spinotectal tract. This spinotectal tract, it is present in lateral funiculus and it extends between spinal cord and tectum, that is the posterior part of midbrain, is called as tectum, and in this tectum there is superior colliculus. So this tract, it connects dorsal root neurons of spinal cord with the neurons of the superior colliculus. Function of this tract, it forms the part of spinousal reflex. What is meant by this spinousal reflex? That is the turning of head and eyes towards the side of nociceptive stimulus. It also conducts slow pain fibers. This is the function of this spinotectal tract. What is the function? It carries the slow pain fibers and also it forms a pathway of that spinovisual reflex. Now for this spinotectal tract, the fibers arising from this tactile receptors, that is the from the nociceptive receptors, peripheral processes of these dorsal root ganglia neurons carry these sensations. Central processes, they carry to this dorsal horn, this relay in the neurons of dorsal horn. Then these fibers cross to the opposite side and goes to contralateral lateral funiculus, and they continues as the spinotectal tract. And this spinotectal tract, then it ascends upward through the medulla pons and they terminate in the superior neurons of the superior colliculus. This is the spinotectal tract. Then spinoalveolar tract. This spinoalveolar tract, function of this spinoalveolar tract, it is similar as that of the spinocerebellar tract. So what is the function of this spinocerebellar tracts? These tracts carry proprioceptive sensations to the cerebellum, that is the unconscious proprioceptive sensations carry to the cerebellum. And the spinoalveolar tract, it also functions same, that is it carries proprioceptive sensations at the unconscious level to the cerebellum, but that is through the olivary nucleus which is situated in medulla. Peripheral processes of this dorsal root ganglia, they carry these sensations, proprioceptive sensations. Through these central processes, they are carried to the posterior horn. They relay in the neurons of posterior horn. Some fibers cross, some ascend on the same side as the oleocerebellar fibers, and they relay in the olivary nucleus, which is situated in, that is the inferior olivary nucleus, mainly medial and dorsal accessory olivary nuclei, which are situated in medulla. And from these, the fibers, they are carried through inferior cerebellar peduncle to the cerebellum. Then spinoreticular tract. This reticular formation, that will be studied in your physiology in detail. So this reticular formation, it is present in brainstem, that is in the medulla pons and midbrain. So these fibers, they connect neurons of spinal cord in dorsal horn with the reticular formation. And main function of this spinoreticular tract, that is it carries the sensation of deep pain, and which is important for the emotional behavior, then arousal response and the autonomic functions. So through this spinoreticular tract, this deep slow pain fibers, they are carried to the thalamus and then to the various areas of cortex which are responsible for the arousal response. This is about these minor tracts, ascending tracts, which are present in spinal cord. This table, it shows features of these ascending tracts present in various funiculi. In this, name of the tract, location of tract, origin, termination and functions of tract. So this fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus, it is situated in posterior white column, that is the dorsal funiculus. Origin, that is these are the central processes of the neurons of dorsal root ganglia. Then these fibers of fasciculus gracilis, they first terminate on neurons in nucleus gracilis and nucleus cuneatus, and from this nuclei they terminate in the ventral posterolateral nucleus of thalamus. Function they convey the sensation of body position and joint movements, vibration and deep pressure and fine touch. Anterospinocerebellar tract present in lateral white funiculus. The cells or origin, it is present, cells of origin, they are present in posterior horn of spinal cord, mainly in the lamina 5, 6 and 7. Fibers cross to the opposite side of the spinal cord. Then again they cross in the midbrain through the superior cerebellar peduncle and then terminate in the anterior vermis of cerebellum. And function is, they carry unconscious proprioceptive sensations from group of muscles of lower part of body. They also carry some extraceptive sensation to the unconscious level. Posterior spinocerebellar tract, it is situated in lateral white column. Origin, that is the cells, they are located in the nucleus dorsalis, that is the nucleus of Clark's column, and it is an uncrossed tract. Then fibers, they pass through inferior cerebellar peduncle and they terminate in the cerebellum, that is the vermis of the cerebellum. Function, they carry unconscious proprioceptive sensation from the individual muscles. Anterospinocerebellar, that carries proprioceptive unconscious sensations from the group of muscles, but this posterior spinocerebellar, that carry sensations from the individual muscle. Then lateral spinothalamic tract, it is present in lateral white funiculus or lateral white column, and cells located in the posterior horn, that is mainly in the substantia gelatinosa and the nucleus propreus. These fibers, they cross to opposite side and they terminate in the ventral posterolateral nucleus of thalamus. Function, they convey pain and temperature sensation from the contralateral side. Anterospinothalamic tract, it is present in anterior white column. Cells of origin, they are present in the posterior horn of spinal cord, terminate in the neurons of ventral posterolateral nucleus of thalamus, and it carries sensation of crude touch, pressure, sensation of itch and sensation of tickle. So this is about the ascending tracts of spinal cord. Now, next lecture, it is on the descending tracts of spinal cord, and we will see that lecture on the next Monday. Thank you. Good day.